Hey guys, how's it going? Remember when we did that Looney Tunes video where we bought a lot of Looney Tunes and tried to basically go from knowing nothing about the game to owning a full set of the game and nearly getting there? Well, as you might remember, we chose Looney Tunes by picking one random card out of five. But when we looked at the other four, or when Laura saw the other four, because I'd written them down, there was one that she really wanted to do, and that was The Nightmare Before Christmas TCG. And I figured, hey, it's coming up to Halloween, and it might be fun to make Laura do some work for the channel.
Oh.
So, in this video, Laura is going to do all the research into... I don't know what that was. Laura is going to do all the research into The Nightmare Before Christmas TCG. She's going to, you know, find out everything she can. We're going to order some stuff. She's going to open it. Going to see how close to full set she gets. So, Laura, over the next couple of days, I need you to start researching the game.
Oh, boy. Just Nightmare Before Christmas TCG?
Yep, look into it, find out what you can, and we'll go from there.
Okay.
All right, Laura, you've had some time to do some research. What have you found out about The Nightmare Before Christmas game?
I have a whole lot of research.
All right, tell us about it.
So it was released in 2005. I knew that it was, you know, no longer being published, but with how popular The Nightmare Before Christmas still is, it could have come out this year and I wouldn't be shocked.
Very popular film.
So, released in 2005, published by NECA, and I found a lot of information on the Quixotic Games website, which still has pretty much everything.
Yeah, I'll put a link to that in the description of the video.
From when the game was coming out. So, first off, I looked up kind of the goal of the game, and the goal, kind of overarching, is to create the scariest version of Christmas.
Okay.
Kind of goes along.
Without seeing any cards isn't really something we know what that means.
Right.
But we'll see some cards soon.
Makes sense. Goes along with the movie.
Yep.
So there were three sets listed online. I'll go into that more later. But the boosters had 8 common cards, 3 uncommons, and a rare card.
Okay.
You can also get ultra rare foil cards. And according to my research, they come in place of a common. About 1 in every 9 packs.
So it should be about 4 per boost box. So then you need boost boxes with 36 packs.
Yeah. So there are 4 different types of cards. I don't know if that's going to be super important, but there are characters, locales, surprises, and creations.
Okay.
And there can be more than one type. There can be more than one card with the same name, but it will have a different alias.
Okay.
So we could get many jacks.
We'll see that probably as we go through it. There'll be different jacks and stuff.
Mm-hmm. So the sets, there was a premiere set that was just The Nightmare Before Christmas. There was a set called Christmas Town. And then there was a set called The Real World. So the premiere set included 153 cards, which was 50 commons, 50 uncommons, and 38 rares, with 12 of the ultra rare foils.
Which means that you need at least 3 boxes to complete that set.
And there were 2 fixed cards that were in the starter decks only. I'm not even sure that they're really functional cards as part of the game. It seems like they're kind of counters.
Okay, well, I'm sure we'll see that when we get to opening stuff.
And there's one promo card for the premiere set.
Okay.
Called the Nightmare Before, or just Nightmare Before Christmas.
Okay.
The Christmas Town expansion is 132 cards. We've got 46 common cards, including 2 rules cards, it says here.
We'll see. We'll see what that means as we open it.
Yeah, 40 uncommons, 40 rares, and then only 6 ultra rare foil cards in that set.
So technically a box and a half could complete that set.
There were 4 starter decks. They were all alongside the premiere set. They focus around, there's one for Jack, the Mayor, Oogie Boogie, and Dr. Finkelstein.
Right.
Each of them has only 48 cards.
I'm assuming that's how many you need to play a deck.
Right. And it's the only way that you can get the Pumpkin Points card and Pumpkin King card.
So those must be those are the two fixed cards to the deck.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then there was an 8-card tournament pack with 3 foils in it. So there's a Barrel, Lock, and Shock, the 3 trick-or-treaters.
Okay.
Those were the 3 foils.
Foils.
And then there's House of Cards, Old Sparkly Snake and Spider Stew, Everybody Make a Scene, and I think I've got it.
Okay.
So after all my research, I had a couple of questions still.
One, I will say before you go into it, you didn't mention the third set.
Right.
That you just mentioned.
That was a question that I had.
Okay.
So I was able to find out that the third set was called The Real World, but I couldn't find any information about it at all.
Okay.
I also couldn't really find much information on the 8-card tournament pack. I was able to find images of all 8 cards, kind of implying that they existed, but right. I couldn't find any on, like, eBay, yeah. Any information anywhere else on the web other than basically they existed. So I emailed one of the creators of the game, and he was very excited to help out, and told me The Real World had been a scheduled set, but it was canceled prior to any work being done on it.
Okay, so it didn't even get into the design phase.
Right, no designs, no cards for it, just straight axed, which is unfortunate because yeah. I think I would have liked to see that set.
Yeah, and that would have been basically all 3 locations that they go to in the movie.
Right.
Because I think the Nightmare Before Christmas set, if that covers Halloween Town, mm-hmm. then they did Christmas Town, and then The Real World is the other location that mm-hmm. they're in the movie.
So that would have been really cool.
Yeah.
And then the 8-card tournament pack. I wasn't really understanding how everything was given out, if they ever were given out, and kind of why there wasn't very much information about it. So what I found out from him is that they did run tournaments. They did send out these tournament packs to locations, but they were pretty rare. It's something that he had a couple extras after the set came out and has gotten rid of them all at this point.
Unfortunately.
Yeah, unfortunately. And he said that pretty much all of these cards are with collectors who are going to want to keep them.
Yeah.
There weren't very many. I didn't get an exact number on how many packs had gone out. But he was very adamant that, yeah, these are gone. They are with people that want them. And, you know...
It's going to be a long time before you see any.
Right.
Before you see any come up for sale.
Yeah, that you could just never see any come up. Which... Yeah. Kind of interesting that there's such a rare part of
yeah, and I think game. There's a lot of games that came out around that time where there will be certain cards like that where they just had such a limited run either because of the game ending or because they just didn't anticipate how many people would want them
mm-hmm.
and the games have surged in popularity. I know the Lord of the Rings game, there's a few promos which are in the hundreds of dollars because they were released through I think was some sort of league play. I think organized play stuff from
right.
card games that die out tend to be the rarest stuff because just so few places run organized play for games that aren't very popular. So it tends to be like that with a lot of card games.
Mm-hmm. So unfortunate, but one really awesome thing that came about is Andrew, who's the designer I was speaking with, offered to actually send me some of the promos for Nightmare Before Christmas.
That's very cool.
So even though we may never get that 8-card tournament set,
yeah.
we
got the other promo.
Yeah, we've got the other promo, so we might be able to complete everything else.
Yep, that's the hope. So that was all your research. Obviously, I said I'd done some research as well beforehand.
Mm-hmm.
You pretty much hit everything that I had already seen. Obviously, I didn't email any of the designers.
Sure.
As far as I got on The Real World was that I knew it was an unreleased set. I obviously didn't know how far it had got. And I did know that the 8-card tournament set is like gold dust. I'm in some Facebook groups for like dead CCGs and stuff, and you see people all a lot of time offering money for them, but you don't see them sell. They just never, ever come up. So, based on what we've seen for how many cards are in each set, what we're going to order is we're going to order all of the decks, mm-hmm. and we're going to order 2 boxes of each set. Now, that will mean that we cannot complete the premier set from what we order, but there was, 38 rare cards in the set. So any more than 2 boxes, we're probably going to be getting so many duplicate rares
sure.
that it wouldn't make sense to be buying a third box just to try and get those extra few foils when I don't think the foils themselves are very expensive. Christmas Town is going to be possible for us to complete with 2 boxes.
Probably unlikely, but...
I mean, the six ultra rares, so if you assume that you're not going to get a duplicate ultra rare in a box, the first box we get 4 of them, You get a little bit lucky to get the other two in the second box, but not massively lucky. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to get those ordered, and then next time you see us, we will be opening that.
I'm excited.
Oh, Laura also got dressed up for the occasion. We didn't mention that at the start of this bit.
My jacket glows in the dark.
All right, so let's start with the four decks. Pick which one you want to open first, Laura.
Let's start with the mayor.
All right. Let's move those others out of the way. Yeah. So it's going to be a 48 card deck. I'll zoom in a little bit as you're opening that. Try and open it on camera, Laura. Try to show it off. So
there's a cool little peel.
Yeah. So the back of the box has the round order, so that tells you how to play.
That's convenient.
We're not super interested in playing it right now. We're interested in collecting it. So this is the mayor's deck. So there were two cards obviously fixed to the decks. There was a points card and the pumpkin king card.
Oh, and it comes with a little rule book sealed in there. That's
yep.
Cool.
It's got another nice little peel. You got it.
There it is.
Yeah. Right, so let's take a quick look at the rule book. What's... All right, so it's... Looks to be pretty simple. Explains what TCG is, how to set up the game, etc.
Different cards.
Different phases. All right.
Cool. All right.
Yeah, like I said, we don't want to...
I might dig into that a bit more later and
okay.
See how to play. It did seem pretty interesting.
Yeah.
All right, so we have... Oh, this one's sideways. We have a mayor mobile. Town square.
Just pull one of these out so I have a quick look at it while you're...
Accordion player. His alias is Jimmy. I don't know if... They were ever actually named in the movie, so I don't know if these... I don't know where they got the names from.
Yeah.
There's Beryl, the little skeleton. Bass player Jim. We've got a Jack Skellington.
The Pumpkin King. So that should be one of the exclusives, right?
No, I
no?
don't
okay.
think so.
I thought it was the Pumpkin
keep,
King.
Keep it aside just in case. I think yeah. It's a card actually called Pumpkin King.
Okay.
Lock, little devil. There's the mayor, our elected official. He can't make decisions
Get
for
four
himself.
Four copies of him.
There we go. Mr. Hyde.
So I'm guessing that four copies must be the limit per deck if you get the full four copies.
Sure,
of him
yeah. We have a sax player named James.
Tilt it
Shock.
Up a little bit, Laura. There we go.
That better?
A little bit, yeah.
Okay. Jingle Bells. That's one of the creation cards. A jumbo treat bag. The takeoff ramp, Halloween plans, and a lot of these have things to do with being the mayor.
Right.
Hitch a ride, Moody Mayor, that's a surprise card, public transportation, then back alley, the treehouse, town hall, tree circle. Have Harlequin Demon, Thingamabob, Wolfman, Delightful Hat. Oh, it is a delightful hat. Made from a dead rat. Scorpion Surprise, Town Meeting, and the Pumpkin Points card. And there it is.
Okay,
the
so those
King
are the exclusive things for the deck. So I'm guessing each deck is going to come with those two.
Yeah, so it's, like I said, like this is kind of a counter to keep track of your score. It has the same back, though, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's the same back as the regular cards.
And then the Pumpkin King is basically just some rules reminder text, it looks like.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Cool.
Okay. So do we want to open the other three decks, or do we want to just jump into some booster boxes?
I think let's jump into some booster boxes, because those should all be
standard cards. Yeah, the other three decks are going to be... Yeah, there's going to be nothing else exclusive in there. There's just going to be the additional... It's going to be 48 cards based around them, and then those additional two cards. All right. One thing I did notice as we were opening, There's no numbering on the cards. So there's no way of knowing which... you know, numbers and stuff you're missing. There's also no way of denoting rarity, which is interesting.
Okay.
All right.
At least not that we've noticed.
No. All right, so here's the, I'll zoom out a little bit so we can see that. This is the first booster box of the base set. So pull the packs out of there. We'll start opening some packs. So what we'll do is we'll go through a couple of packs in full show off everything, and then from there we'll then just show off, you know, the big pulls, the ultra rares. We'll see how much we get.
Any interesting text on the?
Nope, not a thing. So it doesn't really give us any extra information other than it's a 12 card booster pack. So all right, open the first one, Laura.
Alrighty.
So it's supposed to be what, 8 commons, 3 uncommons and a rare? Was I think what you had said?
That sounds correct. Alright, so we've got the Mayor, Jack Skellington, the Pumpkin King, the Accordion Player.
Everything
Jimmy.
We just got out of this.
Oh, we got Igor.
Okay.
Faithful Lackey, Hitch a Ride.
I'm guessing these are the commons to start then, since we've got multiples of them in the deck.
Probably, that makes sense. Throw Me a Bone, Double Dead, I'm the Boogeyman, The Crypt, Monster Under the Bed, he is a toe nibbler, Sandy Claws, and Bunny. So maybe this is, I think this is our rare. I'm pretty sure that symbol means rare.
Okay, so there's not anything to note whether it's common or uncommon, but the skull denotes rare.
I believe I remember seeing that.
Right. Okay, so we did double check. So the pack does have the rare at the back. We'll obviously see if that symbol does denote rares. I'll zoom in a little bit because we're now opening stuff a bit more. Anyway. And then the 3 uncommons came before the rare, and the 8 commons start off the pack. So I guess
let's separate out
the uncommons and the commons. Keep the rares on camera. Okay, from now we'll just show you guys the hits, we'll show you guys any ultra rares that we get, and we'll go over the rares and stuff at the end.
There we go.
Okay, so that was 7 commons, then the foil.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Great, so we know that the ultra, when it replaces a common, it comes within the commons, it doesn't go at the end of the pack.
Right.
Alright, sweet. It's gonna be that to sleeve up, and then you should then have your 3
Back Alley, Town Hall, and Corpse Dad Ned.
And then Eureka is the rare. Alright, cool. So we got our first ultra rare.
Yeah, hopefully they always come at the end of the commons like that. That'll make
it
easy.
Definitely.
Is that one?
Oh, yep, yeah, there is an ultra.
Scary Bed.
So that is a location, right?
Yeah.
That is the only ultra rare location, by the looks of it.
Neat. I didn't take enough time to appreciate how nice Shadow on the Moon looks. Scary Bed, I'm a little bit less impressed with the foiling.
With the foiling, okay.
Yeah. But here, you go ahead and sleeve that up.
Alright. So halfway through the first box, we're pretty much where we should be. We have 18 unique rares, so we didn't get any duplicate rares in the first half of the box.
That's good.
I guess it remains to be seen if we're going to get any duplicates in the second half of the box. We have 2 ultra rares so far, so that is pretty much exactly where we thought we were going to be, because we should be getting 4 ultra rares total per box.
Yeah, so we're doing pretty good. Oh, that's another one. I didn't even notice.
You didn't notice that there was just another ultra rare chilling there?
Yeah.
Is that in the middle of the commons now?
No, that was the end.
Okay, Laura just completely missed that we got another ultra rare.
Yeah, no, he didn't look that foil, but he is very, very much foil.
Yeah,
he looks cool. Good. Here we go, we got another one.
All right, sweet. So that is
Wheel of Torture.
Very cool.
There's a lot of Oogie Boogie in these ultra rares.
I guess he's a character that does look foil really well.
That's true.
The design of how he is.
Yeah, and with him being blacklit in parts of the film.
Yeah. So statistically, we should have all of our ultras from the box now, but you know, we still have quite a few packs left. So I guess maybe there is a chance that you get more than the 4.
We did get one in what, like the first pack of this box though.
This half of the box.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We did get another one.
We did. That's Jack Skellington, Demon of Light. That's a really cool looking one.
That's so awesome.
He's on fire.
Yeah.
During the very opening song, I think.
Yeah. I mean, it makes sense, and we haven't really mentioned, but they do all seem to be cards, or all the artwork seems to be images from the film.
Yeah, I imagine that's everything, is that?
Our rare is the Easter Bunny.
That's adorable.
I love it.
I'm gonna show that again, because hopefully it focuses a bit better.
Oops. Yeah. Look at that foiling. That is really good.
And the last rare of the first box is Say It Twice. And that does mean that from box one, we did get 36 unique rares. There were no duple hits. I hope that means the box is set up like that, which means we're only missing two rares from the set.
That's awesome.
So we're missing the Vampire Prince character rare, and I Am Not the One, surprise. And then, obviously, we've got five ultra rares rather than the four we thought we'd get.
So that's awesome,
pretty great box. So after we finished the first box, we went through and confirmed we did have a full set of all commons and uncommons. Mm-hmm. So just missing those two rares, Vampire Prince and I Am Not the Only One. And then we got five out of the 12 ultra rares. So hopefully, you know, the ones we get now in this box are different ones. Oh, weird. Some of the commons are upside down in this pack. Yeah, they weren't actually printed upside down. They're just upside down in the pack.
The whole rest of the pack upside down.
That's weird.
Here's one.
Ooh.
I Am the Pumpkin King.
That's very cool. It's our first ultra rare of the box. I Am the Pumpkin King.
That's awesome. He's like ripping off his Santa outfit. Here's another one.
Ooh, that's very cool.
Oh, I love that.
Sally, Skilled Alchemist.
I was kind of upset that Sally didn't get her own deck, but I think this...
That is a very, very cool
ultra rare sort of makes up for it. I Am Not the One.
Okay, there we go. So that's one of the two rares we're still missing. So now we just need the Vampire Prince.
There he is.
Hey, there's the Vampire Prince. Straight in the next pack. All right, so give me that. I'll save that up and add it to our pile. So now we're just missing ultra rares.
That's
where we were wanting to be. Yeah. Okay, there's another ultra rare. That is Christmas Casket. So again, another one that we didn't already have. So that's really good.
I like the foiling on this one too, because there's so little of it.
Yeah.
It really stands out.
That's really cool. So now, even though we should be getting at least one more foil in this box, we were exactly where we were hoping to be after two full boxes, which is that we have 8 of the 12 different ultra rares.
Yeah, that's true.
So even if we get a duplicate foil as our last foil in this box, we're still at exactly where we hope to be.
Mm-hmm. I did want to kind of mention this card, the Scary Teddy, just because in everything else I've seen, it's called
Vampire Teddy Bear.
So I don't know why it's just Scary Teddy here. Oh, here we go. It's another
foil.
One. And another one we didn't have.
Dr. Finkelstein.
Ooh.
That's very cool.
See if I can get that to focus better, because that is... There we go.
That's really nice.
Look at that brain.
So that means we are only missing 3 cards from this entire set. They're ultra rare surprises. They're I'm Santa Claus, Look What You've Done, and Sack Full of Mischief. So that'll be something we're looking out for on Facebook or on eBay very soon. And also, while we're still on the premiere set, we have the promo card. This was one that was very nicely sent to us by the creator, or one of the designers of the game. Actually sent us 2 copies of this. This is the Nightmare Before Christmas surprise card.
And I absolutely love it. I think this is a gorgeous card, and I'm really excited to have this promo.
Very cool.
So thank you, Andrew, again. Hopefully they'll get a chance to watch this video and check it out.
All right, let's move on to Christmas Town. So Christmas Town is a bit more interesting stuff on the box. I'll zoom this out a bit so you can see it. So it mentions Santa Claus and the fact that, you know,
he's been kidnapped.
Yeah. The fact that this is set in Christmas Town, which adds new locations and stuff to the game. It's a bit more information than the last box did. And it tells you a bit about playing the game.
Yeah.
So this one, weirdly, is a much smaller set. Well, not much smaller. There's a few less cards for... there's a few less commons and uncommons. There are 2 more rares, so there are 40 rares total.
Interesting.
Hopefully we can still get them all in 2 boxes. But then there are only 6 ultra rares, as we said a bit earlier, so hopefully we can get all 6 of them between the 2 boxes.
Yep.
Obviously they have the same back and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Most TCGs will do that. Some of them do change them, though, between expansions, but this one doesn't. So I'm imagining it's going to be the same thing again. These ones, we know it's got a Christmas tree. So that, I'm guessing, is just a note they're from the expansion.
Yes. And as I was reading up on this, it seems like Christmas Town adds a lot more kind of interesting, more complicated mechanics.
Okay.
So it was really trying to make it more of a complex game.
Okay.
I like Polly the Elf. Oh my goodness. Oh, there's one of the rules cards.
So there are two rules cards that are going to be in the game too.
So that's two of two, it says.
Okay, and it does have just the regular back. Okay. So that's, two of those, two rules cards to help. I wonder if you get a rules card in every pack.
I hope not.
Well, I mean, we're going to get all of the commons and uncommons anyway, so it doesn't really matter.
That's true. I'm just noticing, like, some of the art on these seems a lot crisper. Like, this skating pond is just very clear. I don't know. Yeah, it seems like it's just that one is randomly. Yeah.
So are we still in the commons here?
Are you counting? No. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah,
this. So that's going to be the last common. Okay, and then it changes the color of the expansion symbol.
Oh, that's cool.
So it must be red for the uncommons.
Okay. Lovely. All right,
that is nice. And then...
So look at the spider flake. That's adorable. And then our rare... Oh, rare is in white.
Okay,
that's cool. Neat.
So that is good. So at least we're going to be able to differentiate. So I think there are definite improvements to the expansion in the fact that just having something where you can easily tell by looking at the card what its rarity is. That's huge for any card game. I think every card game should do that if possible. I wouldn't have hated a numbering system. I'd always like a numbering system, but hey.
Yeah, I mean...
We'll take what we can get.
Ooh!
Oh, sweet, our first Ultra Rare.
That's pretty.
That's Santa's Workshop. That is a really nice one.
It is still a white tree like the rares.
But obviously, with it being foil, you can tell it's Ultra Rare rather than rare.
Yeah.
But that is really sweet.
Gosh.
That is a very nice foil card.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Jack Skellington Motivational Spooker.
The puns are strong with this set.
That's cool.
I like
cool
it.
Cool foil.
What's this?
Surprise. That's our third Ultra Rare of the box.
That snowflake, though.
That's very cute.
There it is.
An extendable arm. Alright. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Right, final pack of box one. So, we haven't hit a duplicate rare yet. So, as long as we don't in this pack, then we should just have four rares left to go. Conversations worth having. Yep, that's not a duplicate rare.
Excellent.
So, that is 36 different rares. That means for box two, we're just going to need four rares and two foils. And we'll go sort through the commons and uncommons now, make sure we didn't miss any of those. So, moving on to the second box, we did get all the commons and uncommons, which we pretty much knew we would, because we didn't get any duplicate rares in the first box, which again I think is set up that way. You're never going to get duplicate rares. We're missing four. We're missing Elven Bedchamber, Dr. Finkelstein, Knight of Festivities, and Uninvited Guest. And then because we got the four ultra rares that we were expecting from box one, we're missing two of those. We're missing Give It All Up and Sally Restless Spirit. So fingers crossed on those.
Yeah, that's really not too bad.
All right, two packs in.
Nice.
And we got Sally. Sally Restless Spirit.
She looks awesome.
So we're now down to just needing Give It All Up as the ultra rare.
Sweet. Trying to get it to focus. There we go. It's
a very cool looking color.
Oh, and she's got the flower. Oh, that's so nice.
All right. Well, that is the final ultra rare that we need.
Wow. This, I think, is my
favorite
yet.
That's very cool. That is really cool. I really like how that looks.
The iconic scene with Zero. I love it.
All right, so we have our first duplicate ultra rare. We've got another copy of Jack Skellington. That's quite a good one to get a duplicate of.
Yeah.
All right. Hey. We needed that one, so it's one of the four rares that we needed. Elven Bedchamber. What did I say?
Hopefully this means they'll all be right there.
Yep. I said I bet if we get these, they come all back to back. It's
hey.
Night of Festivities. So hopefully that means that the next pack is going to be Dr. Finkelstein, Desperate Lover, and if it is, it means we have fully completed the Christmas Town set, and we can leave these last 15-ish packs unopened.
I'd be okay with that.
Hey!
Oh, we got an extra Sander's Workshop. That was another really nice one.
Yeah.
So it might be that we hit, if this is Vinkelstein, it means we've hit all four foils. And last rares we need. It is!
Yes!
So we hit all four foils from the box.
There's still quite a few packs, so there could be another foil buried in there somewhere. But
yeah, but we're not going to open them.
It's not worth checking it out.
Alright, so we'll go and get all of this put into a binder, and then we'll go through the binder.
Yeah.
So, everything's in a binder.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go through it. There's a little bit of glare on there. We see a nice page one. We have most of the ultra rares, but we're missing three. So it's I'm Santa Claus, Look What You've Done, and Sack Full of Mischief. But then after that, that is all of the original set, fully complete.
Really excited about that.
Yeah. We have just organized them going by the checklist, which puts ultra rares, then rares, then commons, then uncommons, then commons, mm-hmm. and it put them in order of locales, then characters, then creations, then surprises, and then alphabetical within each of those. The only difference is we put these extra cards on the check and the promo cards at the very end.
Right, we're on the checklist there at the start.
Yeah.
And that promo card, again, that Nightmare Before Christmas, is the only promo for set one.
Yep.
I don't know if I mentioned before, but that was released with a magazine, Scry Magazine.
Okay.
And you could also get it at conventions when they were showing the game off.
So this moves into set two. So as you can see, we have all six of the ultra rares there. You saw us open those. Then move into the rares. Everything there. All rares, all uncommons, and all commons. So set two is totally complete for what we can pull out of boosters.
Mm-hmm.
There are just promos and stuff. Obviously, they've put the rules cards at the end. There are just promos and stuff, but we are going to have to trade a kidney or something for those. The promos and tournament kit and everything that go with set two are very rare. So that's where we're at with the sets. Obviously, we mentioned the promo cards.
Mm-hmm.
Laura, you had another email with the designer after we did those openings, because when we went to the checklist, it wasn't just the tournament kit that went with set two. There were six other promo cards. So what did you find out about those?
So those, similar to the Nightmare Before Christmas set one promo, were released at conventions, not in a magazine or anything like that. But again, are, you know, kind of rare and with people that really wanted to collect this game. So, like you said, not gonna be easy to complete everything for this one.
We should be able to pick up the ultra rares we're missing from set one without too much trouble. It's basically going to be, I think they'll be available either on eBay or on one of the Facebook groups. Mm-hmm. We're just going to have to go and pick those up, which we will do very soon. Obviously, we'll put the word out too that we're looking for those promos, but I'm not hoping. I'm not hopeful. I'm not expecting anything.
Yeah, from everything that I've heard from both the Facebook groups and from Andrew himself, these are a hot commodity.
But it'll be nice to get the sets finished, at least.
Mm-hmm. And this is almost exactly what I've said to you a couple of times as far as a set that I want to try to collect, is something where we can collect everything that comes out of booster packs, everything that would have been available for sale, and not necessarily worry about the promo cards. I know that's not...
I'm going to worry about the promo
your
cards.
Thing, but this is kind of exactly what I was looking for
but
in a game.
But at least this is one where it's not as though they're really available and we just either can't afford them or we have to worry about getting them. It's just they're not available. And
that's
if
true.
They ever come up, we'll hopefully pick them up, but it's just going to be a case of if they ever come up. So that's pretty much everything there is to say, and we're coming to an end of this now. So Laura, what do you think of the game?
I love it. I love the artwork, even though, you know, it's...
It's all from the movie.
Right. But it's a great theme. It seems like it would be a fun game to try to play. It wasn't too hard to pick up the collection for.
Yeah.
Kind of an overall fun, you know, if you like Nightmare Before Christmas, you're gonna like this card game.
Yeah, and if you're wanting to collect it as a set, you can... It is a very simple one and a very easy one to collect as a set if you're just interested in the sets. And then obviously if you are wanting the promos, it's a nice long-term goal that you're going to be working on and searching for a while. Like I said, we opened two boxes of the main set. We're only missing three cards. Mm-hmm. Obviously, if we'd opened a fourth box, there's a good chance we'd have gotten those, or we'd at least have, you know, the extras to trade. The second set, we just stopped halfway through the second box because we were completely done with the set. And I think the boxes I picked up for around $30 a piece.
Which isn't
bad. Which really isn't bad for just trying to finish off the set, considering you need, you know, if you buy four boxes from between the two sets, you're going to be almost done. So for just over $100, if you want to open them yourself, and if you then want to play, you have lots of extra commons and uncommons and some extra rares and stuff to actually start playing
with
too.
Yeah, absolutely.
So overall, I think this was a really good game. I'm really happy that we did this one, that we looked at this one, and that the binder's nearly full.
Yeah.
And that there isn't going to be too much to look at. Obviously, we will do a follow-up video, at least when we get those three missing ultra rares. If we ever get promos or the tournament kit, we'll do follow-up videos showing each of those as we get them. But
yeah.
Hopefully
not too long on those ultra rares, but maybe don't expect any updates anytime soon on those promos.
Yeah. Alright, so I do really hope you enjoyed this video. Hopefully you liked the look at this full game, going from us knowing not very much about it to almost completing it. And, you know, if you want to see us do this for more games, you know, we've done Looney Tunes, we've done Nightmare Before Christmas now, let us know what other games you might want us to look at, and we will consider them. We'll price them up, see how much it will be, how difficult it will be to do that.
And thanks for putting up with me looking into the game this time as opposed to Dan. It was actually a lot of fun, got me really hyped up for, you know, learning more about the game and then getting through and collecting it. Now I really want to finish this set off.
Yep. So, you know, just once again, thanks for watching. We really hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you next time.
Bye.
Thanks for watching. Check out some more videos right here.
And don't forget to subscribe for more awesome content from DJ Gigabyte.
Gotta catch them all.